Welcome to To Your Health. My name is Robin High, and I'm a registered dietitian. I work for Pitt County Health Department.
I'm also a registered dietitian. My name is Beth Wall Bassett, and I'm from ECU Department of Nutrition Science.
And I'm Donna Brooks, breastfeeding peer counselor with the Pitt County Health Department.
There are many benefits to breastfeeding. There are benefits for the infant, including reduction in infections and sicknesses, and also it may reduce obesity, diabetes, and asthma and allergies later on. There's also benefits for the mother after delivery, as well as the environment.
Today we're going to talk about how you can get extra calories and added nutrients throughout the day in practical ways. Donna's going to tell us a little bit about a simple recipe too, a beans and rice recipe.
So Donna, tell us a little bit about how you can get some extra calories in throughout the day in a simple way.
Well, Beth, we have a simple recipe here of three ingredients of beans and rice that you could put together to get in some extra protein as well as some folic acid throughout the day.
All we used is a whole can of black beans.
And you can actually use lentils, you could use pinto beans, you could use whatever kind of canned beans that you have.
And you could also use dried beans.
You could use dried beans.
We also used this, we used brown rice, just cooked brown rice, and this is about a cup.
But you could, Beth, use white rice as well, and you could actually use instant rice if you needed.
The brown rice would add a little bit more, have more health benefits.
Exactly, with the whole grain, yes.
And then our third ingredient is just salsa, and this is about 12 ounces. You could use a 12-ounce jar and just empty that out.
But Beth, you could actually use chopped tomatoes as well to give you some fresh vegetables in there.
Mm-hmm. And all we're gonna do, it's real simple. Just take our rice, prepare it using the directions that are on the package. So if you're using the instant rice, of course it's going to take a little bit less time. But we'll just empty that into our bowl. Then we just take our whole can of black beans or whatever beans you'll use. And then the third thing is just put the salsa on top. You can layer it like this, or if you want to mix it together.
It makes for a very simple recipe that you can eat throughout the day, put it in the refrigerator, and when you sit down to breastfeed the baby and feel like you need a snack, this is something simple that you could eat.
And it's important not just to get the extra calories throughout the day, but we also want to make sure that they're healthy calories.
Beth, you know, it's really important to get approximately 1,800 calories a day when you're breastfeeding. And something that really is important is making sure that you stay well hydrated. Drinking water is a big part of when you sit down to breastfeed a baby. On an average of every 2 to 2.5 hours, you really want to sit down with water and possibly some fruit. Even a peanut butter sandwich on whole grain bread is really important and good source of getting in that folic acid, getting in the protein with the peanut butter. So those are some good choices when you sit down to breastfeed the baby.
Calcium is also important. Eating things like cottage cheese. You could also drink milk, low-fat milk, or have cheese on crackers. These are all pretty simple things to do. You don't have to make it difficult. You can make it easy. You can pick up some quick snacks in between breastfeeding sessions, or you can also put it into the day to remind you, such as like when you sit down, that's when you have a snack. If you sit down to breastfeed, you also drink some water. So you get into a routine of getting enough fluids, but also feeding your baby at regular intervals.
Beth, you know, women need to keep in mind that you need to drink to thirst. You really want to make sure that you're picking from fruits and vegetables, peanut butter, on whole grain bread actually is a good snack when you sit down to breastfeed the baby. On an average of every 2 to 2.5 hours, you're going to be nursing a baby for approximately 10 minutes or so in the earlier days. So you really want to make sure that you do have a snack to sit down with.
how long do you breastfeed the baby over, you know, over time?
The American Academy of Pediatrics suggests exclusively breastfeeding for the first 6 months and then introducing complementary foods thereafter. We at WIC suggest at least a year, and the World Health Organization suggests 2 years or beyond, whichever is mutually desired between mom and baby.
Great.
We'd like to thank Donna and Beth for sharing such great information on breastfeeding tips, as well as this great looking recipe of beans and rice. It really does look great, Beth.
Well, thanks, and it is great. Mmm. That is delicious.
For breastfeeding assistance, if you would contact the Pitt County Health Department breastfeeding program, we have 3 peer counselors that can assist you with breastfeeding classes, home visits, phone counseling. We also have a breast pump loaner program. We're available to help you out with any of your breastfeeding needs.
For more information, for our recipes, visit our website.